Hi, my name is Sanjay, and in this video I'm going to talk about testing as a career choice. In 1946, Grace Hopper, a computer engineer at Harvard University, discovered a moth trapped in one of the computers. The moth was taped on the computer's logbook with the words, "First actual case of a bug being found." It is more than 67 years since that incident, but bugs show no sign of going extinct. In 2011, for example, Toyota recalled more than 150,000 of its Prius hybrid cars. The root cause was a software problem. The Prius had a bug. Software failures have also resulted in deaths. In a series of accidents in Panama City, at least 8 patients died due to overdoses by radiation therapy planning software. Bugs lead to a demand for professionals who are able to detect them, the demand for software testers. Software testing is the process of determining if a software product will be acceptable. A software bug or defect causes software to produce incorrect or unexpected results. These bugs can arise from mistakes made while designing the computer program or writing it. Some bugs may have minor effects on the output and lie undetected for a long time. Others may cause the program to crash. Others have more extreme outcomes, as discussed earlier. Software testing is implemented during different periods in the software development process. Furthermore, though testing is primarily done by testers, it is common for developers or programmers to also test code. A significant task of a tester is to generate and execute test cases. Let's take a simple example. You have written a program that finds the result of dividing two numbers. Thus, your possible input range would include all numbers. But how does the program behave if you try dividing two alphabets? What happens if you divide a number by zero? Testers thus have an attention for detail. They test code written by programmers based on requirements from business analysts. Good communication skills are thus a key attribute in such scenarios. Test cases are read by the testing team, analysts, developers, and even customers. Thus, good written communication skills are a big plus. In general, a technical background is not a prerequisite for becoming a tester. However, there is an aspect of testing called automation testing. The instructions given to such automation tools require some programming exposure. Employees often expect candidates to have at least a bachelor's degree in computer science, engineering, or a related field. In addition, many employers prefer to hire candidates who have attained certification. Now let us look at some of the joys of this role. With testing, you have a bigger picture of the system. You interact with the business to see how a customer will use the software. You also interact with programmers when you run test cases and share your results. The training and documentation teams too may get in touch with you to understand different aspects of the software. As a customer, there's a feeling of satisfaction when a product behaves as you expect it should. A tester thus is like a lifeguard, anticipating and stopping problems before they get to a customer. Many testers find this aspect of their job very satisfying. Now let us look at the other side of the coin. Testing can at times seem repetitive. For example, when a new software version is released, existing functionality may still need to be tested. This aspect is called regression testing. Then you can deal with developers who are quite possessive about their work. When you spot problems, you have to deal with defensive developers. This can be stressful. Lastly, in some companies, testing is not given the importance it deserves. This could make you feel undervalued as a tester. Now let us talk about the prospects of being a tester. One would generally enter the industry as a junior tester. On an average, within 5 years, you could be promoted to a senior tester. A senior tester works with more complicated test scenarios and also mentors junior testers. On an average, within another 2 years, you could move into the role of a test lead or test manager. In a nutshell, this role would involve creating test plans and strategies. Some companies choose to hire test consultants, so consultancy in this space is an opportunity too. Last but not least, diversification into other roles is another common practice. Moving into other roles such as business analysis, project management, and business consultancy are pretty common in the industry. So this brings us to the end of the session. The objective was to give you a flavor of the role. Good luck.